Students, today we'll study about the life cycle of Plasmodium falciparum or malarial parasite. For this, we need to understand three terms: causative agent, vector, and host. Now, what is causative agent? In this case, the Plasmodium, which is a protozoan parasite, is the causative agent. Now, what is vector? Vector in this case is Anopheles mosquito, which is also serving here as primary host, because if we talk about the life cycle part, the sexual life cycle takes place inside the mosquito. Now, if mosquito is the primary host, who is the secondary host? Man is the secondary host, because in this one, asexual cycle takes place. Now, we need to discuss about the vector. Now, Anopheles, which carries or transfer the Plasmodium from one individual to another, serves as vector. Now, we come to the life cycle part. When any infected mosquito feeds on healthy human beings, here you can see sporozoites are coming in blood contact. From the bloodstream, they are going to the liver. Liver cells are also known as hepatocytes. So, inside the liver cells, there are cyzogony which takes place. Cyzogony, you can see here, through cyzogony, there are two types of cryptozoites which form. One is microcryptomerozoites, here it is written as cryptomerozoites, and another is metacryptozoites. Meta means bigger in size, micro means smaller in size. Here you can see, after the liberation of microcryptomerozoites, they are coming to RBC. Here, after the infection or invasion of RBC, they go to the erythrocytic cycle. On the another side, if we see here, exoerythrocytic cycle. So, in this one, metacryptomerozoites are getting liberated, and they will again or reinfect or invade the hepatocyte, and this cycle goes on. Entire these stages are pre-erythrocytic, means prior to erythrocytic cycle. Now, come to the erythrocytic cycle. Here you can see, after the invasion of RBC, they will develop into trophozoite and ring stages. So, you can see the difference. In this one, there is dense cytoplasm. However, here there is a vacuolous structure and cytoplasm is shifted towards periphery. So, this is the difference between trophozoite and ring stage. Why this is called as trophozoite? You can see here, this is related to trophic, means nutritional level. So, this is the feeding stage of the Plasmodium. This will feed on the hemoglobin, which is already present inside the RBC. So, this is the food for Plasmodium. Now, after these stages, next is amoeboid stage. This is irregular stage, which is present inside the RBC. Now, after further development, they will form rosette prior to cyzoont. Basically, cyzoont is not a definite structure. It is development of amoeboid structure to different microcells known as merozoites inside the porous membrane in RBC. So, after formation of cyzoont, here we will discuss about the different species of the Plasmodium. There are four species of Plasmodium. One is Plasmodium vivax, Plasmodium falciparum, Plasmodium ovale, and Plasmodium malariae. Why the Plasmodium falciparum malaria is the deadliest? We can see here, the number of merozoites present inside the cyzoonts are maximum in case of Plasmodium falciparum. Now, after the liberation of, after when the load of this RBC will go beyond the carrying capacity of this, this will get ruptured. And after rupturing of this RBC, there would be many merozoites which will be liberated, and they can again reinfect the RBC, and this erythrocytic cycle goes on. few of the cells or stages under drug pressure or feeble immune pressure will develop into gametocytes. Now, these gametocytes are present inside the body or in bloodstream. So, if any uninfected or normal mosquito will feed on the human being or infected human being, what will happen? These stages will go inside the alimentary canal of the mosquito. Here you can see this is male or micro gametocyte and this is female gametocyte. This gametocyte after X flagellation will form the sperm, and this after maturation will form the egg or female gamete. After the fusion of male and female gamete, there is formation of zygote. This zygote after further development will form oocyanete. This oocyanete is a, here you can see kinete means related to kinesis. This is the stage which can move inside the body. So, this will go to the alimentary canal, and you can see here the space between the wall and the membrane of the alimentary canal. In between this will go and will settle down, and here it will grow further. So, after mitotic division, this will form sporoblast. Now, again when the carrying capacity will exceed here, so what will happen? This will get ruptured and the sporozoites will get liberated inside the body cavity. So, again you can see here these sporozoites are present through body cavity. This will come to the salivary gland of the mosquito. Now, here you can come here. So, this is the sporozoites. So, you can see here ki they again are coming to the bloodstream when any infected mosquito will feed on healthy human being. Now, this cycle will again continue. So, this is the entire life cycle of the Plasmodium falciparum. Now, we need to understand two important concepts. One is pre-patent period, another is incubation period. Now, what is pre-patent period? From the first infection to the first appearance of the parasite in blood, this entire period is pre-patent period, while from the infection to the first appearance of the symptoms is incubation period. Now, we will discuss about the symptoms. So, if you remember from the life cycle part, when the RBCs get ruptured and there is liberation of hemozoin. Hemozoin is the product of the digestion of hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is the food for Plasmodium falciparum or vivax. So, what happens when they digest the hemoglobin? The heme part goes separate and globin part goes separate. Now, this hemozoin, when this comes in the bloodstream, there is a shivering and rise in the temperature that is called as fever. So, this is fever as well as this rupture of the RBC goes simultaneously. If we talk about the treatment of malaria, earlier it was chloroquine which was always given in case of malaria, but now recently a miraculous drug artemisinin has been introduced by the WHO, but as in case of chloroquine it has fallen to resistance, severe resistance globally. So, WHO wants to safeguard the artemisinin, this miraculous drug, from the meanness of resistance. So, they have given the concept of combination therapy. In combination therapy, we cannot use artemisinin alone. We have to use artemisinin with some anti-malarial in combination with artemisinin. So, this is the new concept known as ACT, artemisinin combination therapy, which is very prevalent in case of malaria treatment. In India, this artesunate plus sulfadoxin paramethamine ASP combination is given as the first line of defense.